Well, good afternoon, good evening again. Members of the City Council, members of the School Board, Treasurer Sebelia, Clerk of the Court Fry, Senator Peterson, Delegate Bulova, distinguished guests, and ladies and gentlemen. 2 years ago, I stood before you in this beautiful Veterans Amphitheater and took the oath of office as the 10th individual to serve as mayor of the City of Fairfax. I was then, and as I am now, deeply grateful and humbled by the confidence you have placed in me. To the newest members of the City Council, I wish you congratulations. I look forward to working with you and our returning council members for the people of our wonderful community. To the former members of council, I want to again thank you for your service and wish you the very best in your new endeavors. I have a sneaking suspicion we're going to see you both again. I am very proud of our new City Council tonight. I look forward to the collegiality and mutual respect as we deal with the many challenges that we face ahead. I have known most of the council members for many years and consider them all to be friends. I am certain that we will always find ways to work together, even when we don't always stand together. As mayor, my top three priorities remain clear. One, strengthening our local economy. Two, renewing civic and neighborhood pride. And three, enhancing our quality of life through expanding our parks, recreational, and cultural activities. First, our local economy. I'm pleased to say that the city has turned the economic corner over the past 2 years. Last month, the city's unemployment rate posted its best number in nearly 6 years, just 3.6%. During my first term as mayor, our bond rating agencies reaffirmed our AAA bond rating status, one of only a handful of jurisdictions to achieve this distinction in the Commonwealth of Virginia. However, to keep our taxes low, we must have a strong business community. Our top priorities must be the redevelopment of the Fairfax Boulevard and continuing the progress that we've made in our city's historic downtown. Through our comprehensive rewrite of our zoning ordinance, we are pursuing opportunities to streamline city government, including the lessening of the regulatory burdens that we all face here in the City of Fairfax to do business or redevelop the aging shopping centers we have in our community. This evening, I am also proposing a complete review of our tax structure here in the city. This will include the B-poll tax, or business and professional occupational licensing taxes, the meals tax, the bank franchise tax, and all other taxes that the city levies. While it's too early to predict if major change is needed in our tax structure, I do believe that it's important that we remain competitive in the metropolitan region. Even with this review that I encourage us to undertake, it's important that we keep in mind that city residents still pay the second lowest overall tax rates in Northern Virginia. This fall, we will also partner with George Mason University and the Northern Virginia Regional Commission to explore ways to enhance our historic downtown. To quote a former mayor, who happens to be in the audience, Mayor Mason, the three R's are critical to our downtown success. They include restaurants, retail, and residential. Secondly, I believe we owe it to future generations to preserve our open space, protect our environment, and expand outdoor opportunities for all of our residents. I want Fairfax to continue to be the place where kids and adults alike can play and have fun every day. Just tonight, your City Council approved our Parks and Recreation Strategic Master Plan, the first of its kind for our community. This ambitious plan will serve as a future blueprint for our outstanding Parks and Recreation Department. Most impressive about this plan is that 23% of our community participated in its drafting. As we work to improve our downtown for residents and visitors alike, we will launch a series of events which I hope will meet great success. These include a monthly downtown event dubbed TGIF, Thank God It's Fairfax, and Rock the Block, both beginning next month. Finally, we are a diverse community of hardworking people and close-knit neighborhoods. We all treasure our history, the history we share as a courthouse town, and have tremendous pride in being an independent city. As our neighborhoods age, however, it becomes increasingly important to build civic pride and stronger civic associations. We need to address the unique needs and diverse issues that we have throughout our city. We must enlist residents to help identify and prioritize neighborhood concerns, then engage our city departments and individual civic associations to help make these neighborhoods stronger. If there isn't a civic association in existence, then we ought to start one. We ought to partner with key individuals and start one. Localized issues such as public safety or cut-through traffic or stormwater runoff, these aren't new issues to our community. But I believe our approach in engaging our community can always be improved. Our goal should be to provide meaningful and affirmative change in our neighborhoods and for residents to become more involved in their community and the city as a whole. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been proud to serve on your city council and I'm deeply honored to serve as your mayor. I've often said that the city of Fairfax is rich in history with unlimited possibilities for the future. With your help, we can achieve great things. It's time to get to work. Thank you again for giving me this great honor of serving as your mayor. I won't let you down. Thank you.